Hi, it's Chris, and as a lifelong musician, actor, composer, singer, radio host, and small-time celebrity, I want to bring to you a new concept for TGO, where I've lived for 22 years. But the very first skill I learned was how to dance, starting at 3 years old in a dance studio, and I haven't stopped yet. So before I tell you how, I want to tell you why, with 10 reasons why we should all be dancing. Number one, it gets us in shape and we stay fit. Two, it burns calories. Three, it improves our heart health, our muscle strength, circulation, blood pressure, and stress levels. Four, you get greater flexibility and balance with dance. Five, it is good for bones and joints, especially when we do it carefully. Six, it builds confidence in the things that we do every day. Seven, it's both aerobic and anaerobic for our heart. Eight, it lifts your mood. Nine, it helps memory, circulation, and coordination. And 10, my favorite reason, it's fun. There has been a suggestion that we should be practicing our class in the fitness center. Well, let me explain why I think that's a very bad idea. Number one, the floor is a mat. It will grab your feet and not allow you to turn or pivot or change directions. It can blow out a meniscus. That's very dangerous. That's my number one top reason for not even considering putting a class of dancers in the fitness center. Number two, the mirror is only 6 feet wide. That means you can fit two people with their arms extended in front of the mirror, which then gives you not very much room to do any kind of choreography whatsoever. Number three, I can just see us trying to turn on our loud, upbeat, fun tempo music when there's other people in there trying to listening to TV while they're working out. I don't think they'd like us very much, and I think you'd get a lot more complaints. The rows behind, number four, you can fit two more people behind there, which would give us a class of three, and the instructor. I don't visualize that as being a big dance company that I would have hoped for. Number five, the equipment runs along both sides of the fitness center and is kind of scattered about with the little hand weights and so forth. And if somebody should be taking a turn or, you know, a little bit off balance, that could cause a terrible injury, not just to the equipment, but to the people themselves. And it's way too tight in there to be dancing in any case. So the number six reason is the floor, as I said before, I cannot emphasize it enough, is not appropriate for dancing, period. It might be soft on your joints, but it's not going to help you when you're trying to do choreographed dance moves. Number seven, and if we get complaints about closing the fitness center for a half an hour cleaning, which we are getting quite a number of complaints just for that, imagine trying to close it for a class twice a week for an hour or an hour and a half. I think that may not go over so well. Here's what seems like a slam dunk fit for running choreographed dance classes, and that would be the pavilion, which number one is not scheduled for any kind of renovation, to my understanding, for the next 2 years. So why not utilize the space while we're waiting for that to happen? Number two, we can schedule class times. There's very little use during the summer, especially, and even during regular season, we can schedule around whatever we need for practice time. Number three, things can be easily moved because most everything that's stored there is on wheels. Number four, the concrete floor, although it isn't terribly comfortable for jumping up and down like a class that has aerobics in it, that can accommodate with the proper footwear and preparation, turns, pivots, pirouettes, crossing directions, it absolutely can take that, and it isn't nearly as uncomfortable as ruining a meniscus in your knee. Number five, and the professional mirror company that I have contacted will measure, install, and cut right on the site to our specifications. And they work all over the country. They only install commercial grade fitness center and dance company mirrors. So this is a really good fit, and especially since we're going to raise the money ourselves for it. Number six is all expenses raised by TGO residents with extra money as a prudent reserve kept aside for maintenance in case there's anything that goes wrong. Here's my proposal. Starting from the corner behind the piano, I suggest that we have a professional company install on site and cut the mirrors to size. Here's the before picture, along the back wall behind the piano, all the way across the door, which would be mounted separately, of course, covering approximately 15 feet across. Now here's the after picture, giving approximate placement of the mirrors, which would be 6 by 8 feet across the wall. And in closing, I just want to show you a little clip of the kind of dancing and the kind of music that I would hope that we'd be able to draw a fun crowd and a lot of participants to surprise everybody. Of course, this would be adapted, but take a look at this short video and see what I mean.